Brazilian. So how would you explain, why would you say no to chance and accidents? That's what I'm trying to get at. Go ahead.
Because there's clearly the product of design. I'm saying people are not...
How is this clearly a product of design?
Can I not finish one sentence?
I'm sorry, I apologize. Carry on.
That is clearly the product of design. And I know the fact that it's been designed by humans. My reference to evolution simply attains...
I'm not talking about evolution.
I was talking about evolution.
Then you're having a wrong discussion, I'm sorry. I wasn't talking about evolution either.
You just said there has to be a designer.
I didn't talk about...
Yes, you did.
My friend.
It has to be a designer.
My friend.
Evolution is a classic example of what you claim to be design.
The origin of cosmos, the stars, do your evolutionary theory talk about it?
The origin, I don't believe there is an origin of the cosmos. I don't believe that there is a designer.
Can you, with your evolutionary theories, explain the cosmos, the stars and the galaxies?
Evolution explains the existence of us, not of the existence of
right,
galaxies.
So in the wrong discussion. I was talking about the whole of this universe with the complexity, the stars, Planck's constant dimension, gravitational constant dimension. Are this part of your biology? Excuse me. When we're talking about...
Who made the design? Who designed the design? See, what are the answers to that?
When we talk about the Planck's constants, gravitational constants, we're not talking about biology. We're talking about physics. We're talking about mathematics, right? So, unfortunately, as you see, some of our friends, our brothers in humanity, they came along because they're atheists by their own ideology. They want to bring what they call, what we call a comfort zone, which is evolution of the living things, and impose that to everything else. But when you really examine it, that's why he had to leave, because the stars have nothing to do with Darwinian evolution. Nothing to do with it. So when we examine the life, the complexities of the natural world, the stars and the galaxies and the planets, the water cycle and everything, we are quite clear in one thing. That there is clearly design in there. People out there, they don't want to admit it. Because if they admit that this design, do you know the consequence of that is? They don't believe in God who designed it. So they can't say there is a design. That's what's stopping them. They will say there's an illusion of design. So if you find a human being with an eye better than the camera, they will say the camera clearly demonstrates design, but the eye doesn't. When the eye is better than the camera, in many cases. The brain is better than the computers, okay? Because we are the ones who made the computers. But they will say the computer's design, but not the human brains. So this is coming from the reluctance to accept the overall designer, who is the creator of this universe. There's an Arab proverb, which is very simple to understand. An Arab Bedouin, you know Bedouins, right? The Bedouins in the desert who have camels on the left. So one of the Bedouin said, famous proverb, that the camel droppings point towards a camel that was hanging about here. The camel dropping is evidence of a camel being there. The footprints on the sand, human footprints, is an evidence, it's a direction indication of a traveler which went that way. It wasn't the sand and the wind and the humidity and the temperature somehow made those prints. Clearly evidence of a human being walking there, it's a human footprint. He says, the earth, the stars, the skies, all of this and the working, you know, integral working between themselves is an evidence of the one who created them. Even a Bedouin can understand it. But yet, people somehow, for some reason, they want to come away from this belief in this creator when the evidence is in front of them all around. So when you said you haven't got a particular belief in something, the evidence is all around. This is why in the Quran it says, God says, we will show them our signs, our evidence within the horizons and within themselves, within ourselves, until it becomes clear that this is the truth.
So if I'm an atheist,
if you're an atheist, you're a follower of your own desires, your own self. So you have your own desires, which is directing you to do whatever you want to do. So you've taken your own desires as your ultimate arbiter, ultimate guide, ultimate decision maker, right? Allah tells us in the Quran that there are some people who've taken that, their own desires as their own God.